Hello students, today I have come up with the second part of organic chemistry from class 10 syllabus. Today I'll start with homologous series. Now what is a homologous series? A homologous series is basically a series of organic compounds which follow a definite pattern. And in each of the organic compound, the two adjacent compounds will differ by a CH2 group. Let me show you this. Homologous series. For example, alkanes. The alkanes form a homologous series. All the alkanes will have a general formula of CnH2n+2, where n is the number of carbon atoms. Just look at the series. Methane, ethane, propane, butane, pentane, and the series continues. Now, see, in methane we have one carbon and four hydrogen, but in ethane we have two carbons and six hydrogen. Methane and ethane differ by a CH2 group. If we add one carbon to methane, it will form C2, and two other hydrogens to methane, then it will form C2H6. Again, if we see the formula of ethane and propane, here also we see that ethane and propane differ by a CH2 group. Here also there are two carbons in ethane and six hydrogens in ethane. If we add one carbon to ethane, then C3, and two hydrogens to ethane, then H8. Like this, this is not a reaction. Let me just clarify this. This is not a chemical reaction. This cannot be any sort of a compound. This is not a chemical reaction, nor it is a compound. I'm just showing this to show you that if we add one carbon to ethane and two other hydrogen to ethane, then this will form 2 + 1 = 3, 6 + 2 = 8. This is not any chemical reaction. Okay, again, from propane to butane, there also we see that if we add a CH2, then C3 + 1 = C4, H8 + 2 = H10. For butane to pentane also, it differs by a CH2 group. So all the alkanes form a homologous series. In the same way, for alkenes, CnH2n is the general formula. C2H4 ethene, C3H6 propene, C4H8 butene, C5H10 pentene. Here also you will notice that ethene and propene differ by a CH2 group. See, if we add one carbon to ethene, then it becomes C3, and two hydrogens to ethene, then H6. It will give you propene. Again, propene and butene differ by a CH2 group. Like this, butene and pentene differ by a CH2 group. And the series continues. Alkenes form a homologous series. In the same way, alkynes will also form a similar homologous series. Remember, in all the homologous series, the two adjacent compounds differ by a CH2 group. Okay? Also remember that in homologous series, the general molecular formula remains same for all the members of the series. That is, this general molecular formula is same for methane, ethane, butane, sorry, methane, ethane, propane, butane, pentane, hexane, heptane, all the compounds of alkenes. Okay? Like this, CnH2n for alkenes, this is the general molecular formula for all the alkenes. Understood? Okay. Now, what about the other characteristics of homologous members of the homologous series? Another characteristic is that all the members will have similar chemical properties. All the members will have similar chemical properties. Another thing is important that the molecular weight of the compounds in a particular series increases down the series. That is very easy to understand. For example, methane has a molecular weight for carbon 12, for hydrogen 4:1, which is 16. Ethane, which is just after methane, has a molecular weight 2:12 plus 6:1, 30. Propane has a molecular weight 44. Okay, like this, as we move down a homologous series, we will see that the molecular weight of the organic compounds or the members of the series increases. And it will be more for butane, that will be more for pentane, it will be again more like this. Okay, these are generally the homologous series. This is the basic concept of homologous series. Now I'll come to isomerism. There are mainly two types of isomerism: structural isomerism and stereoisomerism. Structural isomerism and stereoisomerism. In structural isomerism, there are many different parts. But in your syllabus, only you have position and chain isomerism. And in under stereoisomerism, there are optical isomerism, geometrical isomerism, but you only have geometrical isomerism in your syllabus. Now, what do you mean by isomerism? Okay, first let me tell you what are isomers. Isomers are those pairs or those compounds in which the structure is different, but they all have the same molecular formula. This property of the isomers is known as isomerism. Again, let me explain. Isomers are the compounds which have the similar molecular formula, but they have different structural formula. These isomers exhibit a property which is known as isomerism. Okay, now let me come to the example of isomerism, which is very important. Alkenes mainly show chain isomerism. Alkenes mainly show chain isomerism. Now, what is chain isomerism? This is the normal structure of butane, where all the carbon atoms are in a straight chain. This is known as N-butane. Again, if instead of keeping all the carbon atoms in a straight chain, if we keep another carbon atom down, then also this is butane only, since it contains four carbon atoms. This is butane only, but since the carbon atom is branched here, it has a different name, which is isobutane. These two are known as chain isomers. These two are known as chain isomers. Why? Because a straight compound is being branched here. The position of the carbon atoms is just changed. The structure, as a result, since the position of carbon atoms are changed, as a result, the structure changes. This is known as chain isomerism. Another example of chain isomerism I can show you with pentane. This is a straight chain of carbon atoms. This is known as N-pentane, as it contains 5 carbon atoms. Okay? Now, writing all the carbon atoms in a straight chain, if we bring a carbon atom here, then this compound is known as isopentane. Listen to one thing, that here all the carbon atoms consist of hydrogen atoms and are attached to carbon atoms either on one side or on two sides. But look into this isopentane. Here, this carbon atom is being attached to carbon atoms in three sides. Now, if you come to the next structure, look into this structure. This also consists of 4 carbon atoms. 5 carbon atoms, sorry. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 carbon atoms. Look at the central carbon atom. Here the central carbon atom is attached to 4 other carbon atoms on the 4 sides. This is known as neopentane. These three are chain isomers. Okay? These three are chain isomers. Since you can see the chain is continuously increasing, means it is being branched from straight to this to this. They are known as chain isomers. Okay? Now I'll come to alkenes. Alkenes show chain position as well as geometrical isomerism. Here you can see this. This compound's name is 1-butene. Why 1-butene? Because 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 carbon atoms and the double bond is in one position. I will teach this while teaching IUPAC nomenclature. This compound is known as 1-butene. As soon as I change the position of double bond, see here also 1, 2, 3, 4, the position of double bond is changed from one first carbon to second carbon. This compound's name is 2-butene. Okay, see the position of double bond is being changed from first carbon, here second carbon. This is known as position isomers. These two compounds are known as position isomers. They have the same number of carbon atoms, but the position of double bond changes. Okay, now if I show you how they will form chain isomers, this is position isomer which I showed you earlier. Now I'll show you chain isomer. I will take this 1-butene only. Look at this. This carbon will not be attached to any hydrogen since 4 valencies is being satisfied. Look at this. This is a straight chain of carbon atoms and here we have just taken another carbon atom. Instead of in a straight chain, we have taken it this as a branched, in the branched form. Okay, these two are known as chain isomers. Now I'll show you geometrical isomers of alkenes. These are the two CH3 groups. You can also write like this. Instead of writing like this, you can also write like this. But in case of the geometrical isomerism, we do not write in the branched structural form. We generally write the condensed structural form. If we write CH3 like this, this is the condensed structural form. But if we write one H here, another H here, and the other H here, this is the branched structural form, but we generally write the condensed structural form. See, here the two methyl groups are on the same side, the two hydrogens on the same side. Look at this, the two methyl groups on opposite sides and the two hydrogens on opposite sides. These two are known as geometrical isomers. Geometrical isomers. The alkene consisting of similar groups in similar same site is known as cis isomer, C-I-S, cis. And the alkene consisting of the same groups in opposite sites, trans. This is the cis isomer, this is the trans isomer. They are known as geometrical isomers. Okay, one thing here, I forgot to change that I'm just talking about alkenes, okay? I forgot to change the heading. Please change the heading that this is for alkenes, not for alkanes. Okay? This I forgot before. I've told you, but I forgot before, so I'm telling that now, that these are not alkenes. This three does not happen for alkanes. These three happen for alkenes. So, the heading has to be alkenes. Just change from alkanes to alkenes. Okay? Okay. The next I'll come to alkynes. In alkynes, okay, this is the structure of 1-butyne, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the structure of 1-butyne. But if we change the triple bond from one position to two position, then again 1, 2, 3, 4, this is 2-butyne. These are again position isomers. And alkynes mainly show position isomerism. Alkynes mainly show position isomerism. Okay? Okay? This is all about isomerism. From the next video, I'll start with IUPAC nomenclature. I'll talk about the various functional groups and then I'll start with IUPAC nomenclature. Thank you.